Hello world, it's Siraj. In this video, we're gonna create a neural network that makes images become really trippy using Python and TensorFlow. We humans have been using psychedelic drugs since prehistoric times.
That wasn't a normal mushroom.
They help manifest parts of our mind to conscious experience that wouldn't normally otherwise. One of the most common experiences from psychedelics are trippy visuals. People who've taken psychedelics repeatedly describe experiences of seeing both open eye and closed eye visuals. But how? What are these drugs doing in our brain that makes us see things that aren't really there? The traditional way for us to find out is to test live human subjects tripping balls under an fMRI machine. But recently, we've gotten artificial neural networks to do the same thing. Google trained a neural network on a labeled dataset of images, everything from squirrels to temples. And as it trained on these images, it built internal representations at each layer. Eventually, the first few layers learned low-level features like lines and edges, and they got progressively more abstract. So the last few layers learned representations for faces and big shapes. So when we visualize one of the higher-level representations it built, we can see that it contains a mixture of features like the eyes of a dog and the head of a bird.
Ugh.
And when they gave it a novel image and asked not to classify it, but to maximize the similarity between the image and a representation at a particular layer, the result was a very trippy image. It all sounds very similar to the drug experience, which is insane. Our brains are carbon-based, and they use chemical signals as messengers. A neural network doesn't even exist in physical space at all. It's an abstract concept being represented on binary silicon transistors. There's no reason to expect that these two systems would develop the same mechanism for processing visual information. Even with existing similarities, natural selection is very different from using gradient descent to alter weights of connections between nodes. Could it be that somehow encoded into the fundamental rules of the universe, there is this ideal way of doing object recognition?
What is he doing?
He's beginning to believe.
You're damn right, Morpheus.
We're getting closer to understanding it every day, and we can learn a lot about the brain, including human development, treatment for cognitive disabilities, and drug effects from studying artificial neural networks. After we install our dependencies, we're gonna replicate Google's Deep Dream code in TensorFlow and then test it out on a novel image. NumPy will be used to perform math calculations. The partial submodule of func tools lets us create new versions of functions with one or more arguments filled in. This is good for reusability, which means less code to write. Pillow is an imaging library, and image will help us modify our images. TensorFlow is our machine learning library. URLLib will let us download data from the web. OS will let us use operating system dependent functionality, and zip tools will let us run free. No, it'll just let us unzip files. Our imports are already at the top of our script. So we're gonna download Google's pre-trained neural network, create a TensorFlow session, pick a layer in the pre-trained network to enhance our input image, apply our gradient ascent to that layer repeatedly, and then output our newly deep-dreamed image. Let's start by downloading Google's pre-trained neural network called Inception in our main method. We'll store a link to it in the URL variable, create a data directory where we will extract it to, then use the OS module to retrieve the model name and create a local zip file path. If there is nothing at that path, we can download it using the URLLib module with the URL variable as a parameter and store it in the model URL variable. We'll open our zip file with the WB flag so we can write to it in binary, then write the downloaded data to it. Then we'll extract that using the zip file module. Now we can create our TensorFlow session. We'll load our inception graph file into our model FN variable, then initialize a graph using the graph function of TensorFlow. Now we can initialize a session using that graph. We'll open our existing saved inception graph using the fastg file function and point it to the saved graph. Once we opened it, we can read that graph and parse it accordingly using the parse from string method of TensorFlow's graph definition module. We need to define our input, so we'll create an input tensor using the placeholder method called input with a size of 32 bits. Then we'll define the ImageNet mean value of pixels in an image as 117. By removing this value from our image, it will help us with feature learning, so we will subtract it from our input tensor and store the value in our pre-processed variable. Then we'll load the graph def variable we initialized with the input as a newly processed tensor. So now we've got our TensorFlow model, we've downloaded from the web, and we've loaded it into our session as a graph with a bunch of layers. It's a convolutional neural network, the type of neural net that helps recognize images. Let's load all those layers into an array and store them in our layers object. So for every TensorFlow operation in our graph, if it's a convolutional layer, loaded into our array. So we've got layers, we're balling hard right now, I know. Okay, so each of our convolutional layers outputs tens of hundreds of feature channels to pass data in the graph, and we can collect them all and store them in the feature nums variable. Let's print them out and visualize what we've got in terminal first. We can see our number of layers and the total number of feature channels right here. Let's now pick a layer from our model that we're going to enhance. We'll pick a lower level layer and pick one of the feature channels to visualize. It's time to load our input image using the pillow image submodules open method and store it in our image variable. We'll format it accordingly using NumPy and perform deep dream on it with our render deep dream function with a focus on the layer we selected earlier. In our deep dream function, we can see a couple of our predefined hyperparameters. We'll start by defining our optimization objective, which is to reduce the mean of our input layer. The gradients function lets us compute the symbolic gradient of our optimized tensor with respect to our input tensor. Now we can split our image into a number of octaves and say for each octave, let's resize it using NumPy and add it to our array of image octaves. Then we can generate details octave by octave by iterating through each. Random shifts are applied to the image to blur tile boundaries over multiple iterations using the calc grade tiled function. We're essentially applying gradient ascent here to maximize our loss function, which merges our saved representation in this layer with our input image more and more every iteration. So to break it down, neural networks are a great testbed for learning about how the brain functions and responds to certain stimuli. They store increasingly abstract representations of what they learn in their layers. And we can create trippy images by applying a gradient ascent process to them based on any chosen layer of a pre-trained convolutional neural network. The winner of the coding challenge from the last video is Avhirup Chakraborty. He created a pretty cool IPython notebook to demo his code and trained his neural net on both price and sentiment data using Keras. Badass of the week. And the runner-up is Victor Ciarana, very well-documented code that asks for user input on stock prediction. The coding challenge for this video is to modify this code so it works not just on images, but video. Details are in the README. Post your GitHub link in the comments and I'll announce a winner in the next video. Also, I created a Slack channel for all of us programming wizards to learn from each other. Link to sign up below. For now, I've got to stay sober, so thanks for watching.